Hello and welcome to another Fabula Ultima class feature. This is the Weapon Master, which is the last class in the core rulebook. So we finally made it, everyone. Which is, you know, I've been excited to reach this far. But yeah, so this is a guide by Fabula Points. Me! Jumping straight in. The free benefits we get with the Weapon Master, who is our fighter kind of warrior class, is that you permanently increase your maximum hit points by 5, which is great, and you gain the ability to equip martial melee weapons and martial shields. Note, you don't get the ability to equip martial armor from this class. If you want to be like super armored, you'll have to get that elsewhere. So skills. There are 13 skill points that you can allocate to the Weapon Master, so this becomes less about what skills you want to take and more about what skills you don't want to take. So, for example, if you are going to max Weapon Master and get to level 10 in it, you can completely ignore Breach if you wanted, or say, for example, if you weren't keen on Bone Crusher, you'd have to take one skill level in Bone Crusher. You couldn't skip it because of how the points go. So keep in mind when building a Weapon Master, like, your choice of what not to take is kind of bigger than what to take because of the limited amount of skills you can put in. But speaking of the skills, Bladestorm. When you perform a melee attack, you may spend 10 mind points to choose one option. The attack gains multi 2, or you increase the attack's multi property by 1 up to a maximum of multi 3. Like, this is good. Like, there's nothing wrong with it. 10 mind points isn't that much, especially if you are a kind of melee fighter and you may not have much use for your mind points. So yeah, this isn't bad. And even though you can buy weapons that have like multi 2 on it, for example, this gets it up to multi 3. And obviously, if you have a multi 2 weapon and there's only 2 enemies, you just don't need to blade to them. Like, it's only 1 point. So yeah, I don't see anything wrong with it. Pretty solid. But there are other options that I think are better, but that doesn't mean you can't take it. Bone Crusher. You can do up to 4 points in this. So when you hit one or more targets with a melee attack that would deal damage, you may have the attack deal no damage. If you do, choose one option. You inflict dazed on each target hit by the attack, or you inflict weak on each target hit by the attack, or each target hit by attack loses skill level times 10 mind points. So if you remember, this is very like similar to Warning Shot, or not similar. It's basically the same as Warning Shot. Except this time you do dazed and weak, where Warning Shot for the sharpshooter you do shaken or slow. So it's the same kind of deal where it's a quick, easy way to get some conditions on someone, which is fine. So again, with the amount of skill points you have, were you to take 1 point in Bone Crusher and have max everything else, you'd be able to do dazed or weak on whoever you wanted. It's just when you do the attack that does mind points, you wouldn't do quite as much as if you maxed it. So if you're not regularly like attacking people's mind points, this might be the one to kind of take a point in, but not necessarily. The next one, Breach. You can do 3 skill levels in this, and you may use an action to spend 5 mind points to perform a free attack with a melee weapon you have equipped. This attack must target a single creature. If the attack is successful, it deals no damage and you choose one option. Either you destroy one shield equipped by the target, or you destroy the target's equipped armor, or whenever the target suffers damage from a source before the start of your next turn, that source deals skill level times 2 extra damage to them. I think this is amazing. Like, if you have like a super armored boss, you can do turn 1, wreck their shield, turn 2, wreck their armor, and then everyone's hitting them better. Like, it's like, especially at the start of a fight, this is fantastic. I'm not that keen on the last part where they take skill level times 2 extra damage, because even maxing this, that's only 6 extra damage, which obviously adds up if you have a large party. But I feel like you can do an attack that will do, like, that might be able to do other things and be more useful than have like your team potentially deal 6 extra damage. They have to hit, and it would have to be they'd have to hit and they might not. So like, it's not bad, the extra damage, but I feel like other things are stronger. Next one is Counterattack. I think this is essential. But obviously, it's your choice, you don't have to. So, after an enemy hits or misses you with a melee attack, which is massive, If the result of their accuracy check was an even number, you may perform a free attack against that enemy after their attack has been fully resolved. This attack must be a melee attack and must have that enemy as its only target. You treat a high roll as zero when calculating damage dealt by this attack. So this is fantastic. So basically, like, statistically, half of the time you're targeted, whether you take damage or not, you can attack back. So you can build like a build around this, because not only can you like, can you just, it does it deal extra damage like basically for free, but if you have like lots of skills that will add damage to your attacks, then you can ramp the damage of this up, even though you treat your high roll as zero. And even that, there's a heroic skill which we're covering later, which negates that. But yeah, I think counterattack's amazing, and it definitely like lends itself into like the kind of Final Fantasy-ish vibe, because like you can get counterattack on basically all Final Fantasy games. Like, there's probably a few you can't, but all the ones I've played, you can pet counterattack on people anyway. So yeah, I think this is awesome. Then the last one, melee weapon mastery. You can put 4 skill points in. You gain a bonus equal to skill level to all accuracy checks with melee weapons, which is great. Like, you know, it's +1 to +4 to hit. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. Everyone wants to hit more often. So yeah, that's the basic skills. So I needed to stop saying this kind of thing, but again, like, you need to pick what you don't want more than what you want with the Weapon Master. So have a think of what seems less likely that you'll want, and then build a Weapon Master around that. But it's not just skills we need to talk about, it's also heroic skills. So there are 2 from the core rulebook that we can look over, but there's an enormous amount from the High Fantasy Atlas. There's 8. So there's 10 skills to look at here. So, jumping straight through. The first one from the core rulebook, Powerful Strike. So when you hit one or more creatures with a melee attack, that attack deals 5 extra damage to each creature, you know, which is fantastic. The extra amount of damage increases to 10 if you're level 40 or higher. So this is one of those skills where, like, it's, you know, it's pretty simple, like, but it consistently performs. So, like, I like it. Like, if there's something else that's more exciting for you, then obviously take the more exciting one. But if you're not sure, every single one of your attack dealing more damage will add up very quickly. So yeah, I think it's pretty solid. But the next one, Tempest Strike, is on the next page. Tempest Strike. When you perform a melee attack with the multi-property, if you choose to target only one creature, the attack deals 5 extra damage if the attack had multi-2, or 10 extra damage if the attack had multi-3. Now, if you really like the idea of this and the flavor of this, then obviously go for it. But from like a pure numbers power gaming perspective, this is completely outranked by Powerful Strike. Like, there's... the only time it isn't is if you're below level 40 and you have multi-3 and choose to not hit the other 2 targets. And if you pay attention, it's as if you choose to target only one creature. So if you don't have the option and you're only fighting one creature, you can't choose. The choice is made for you. So this doesn't apply. So if you're fighting a boss and this is only him, like, this doesn't even apply. So just take Powerful Strike if you want numbers, because, you know, why sacrifice your multi when Powerful Strike applies to multi because it deals extra damage? Like, it just doesn't make sense to me. Like, it sounds cool and you can flavor it well, but from a numbers perspective, it's just worse in my opinion. But let's look at the High Fantasy Atlas. There's 8 of these to go through. So, Arcane Mark. When you hit one or more creatures with an attack using a weapon that belongs to the arcane category, so that's like your staves and tomes, when the attack deals 5 extra damage, and you may choose one of those creatures. If the next offensive spell you cast during this scene only targets the chosen creature, its magic check will trigger a critical success if both dice show the same number and the check is not a fumble. So this is a bit complicated, but that's fine, because I don't advise anyone take it. Like, 5 extra damage on a weapon type that typically doesn't deal much damage, like, is fine, but like, you're setting yourself up to make you possibly miss less the next round, when instead you could have 2 rounds of magic attacks. So like, I feel like you just try twice, because if you hit twice, you do the attack twice. Like, Like, I don't know, it's just I really don't like it. Like, the Fury gets a chance to do this, admittedly with a small amount of weapons, that they can just always have it on every attack, and you don't need to waste a turn really to do it. Like, obviously, like, you don't quite waste it because you deal a little bit of damage that has 5 extra damage added on top, but I feel like 2 turns of spells would just outpace this. So yeah, I don't recommend it. Obviously, again, if you want to flavor it, go for it, but it's not for me, Arcane Mark. Next one, Blade Adept. When you have one or more melee dagger weapons equipped, you gain a +1 bonus to defense and magic defense, and you treat those weapons as belonging to the brawling, sword, and thrown categories for the purposes of skills and effects. Additionally, your attacks with weapons that belong to the dagger category may target creatures that cannot normally be targeted by melee attacks. So, this is if you want to take a dagger build, this is a good way to enhance your dagger build. The extra bonus to defense and magic defense is never anything to turn down, like, on its own, because, you know, who wants to be hit less, or who doesn't want to be hit less even? But, like, it's gonna, like, really depend on your other skills, because, like, it's very specifically brawling, sword, and thrown. Like, if you have skills from other classes that affect these that you really want to do, but you want the aesthetic of wielding daggers, or you've got really good daggers that you don't want to give up, like, you could. But, like, again, there's ways to get extra defense and magic defense. You can just buy better gear, and, like, you can just probably get a throwing dagger that you can just buy. Like, I'm not a fan, really. Like, there's, I don't know, not a fan. I'm just gonna move on rather than ramble, because there's a lot of these. Fleeting Moment. When you perform a counterattack using a melee weapon that belongs to the sword category, you may add your high roll to the damage dealt by the attack. You don't have to treat it as being zero. Like, I like it, but I don't like that it has to belong to sword. Like, I don't understand why you can't just have it with whatever weapon you've got equipped. Like, but, you know, if you take counterattack, which you should, I love it, and you regularly counterattack and you want the extra damage, like, go for it. But, like, again, from a numbers perspective, you'd probably be better off taking Powerful Strike, because that applies to your normal attacks as well, and it would apply to your counterattack. So instead of adding your high roll to the damage, you get 5 damage if you're below level 40 or 10 if you're above. So, like, you know, you can obviously, you don't have to only take one weapon master skill, a heroic skill, if you don't choose to take a heroic skill from another class. But, like, again, Powerful Strike's just so good. Right, next one, Iron Forest. After you hit one or more creatures with a melee attack using a weapon that belongs to the spear category, very specific, if you have no other weapons equipped, you may spend 20 mind points, which is a lot, and choose one of the creatures. If you do so, the attack deals half the normal amount of damage for each of its targets, and you choose the type of action among the following: attack, guard, objective, spell, or skill. From now on, the chosen creature must spend 10 mind points whenever they wish to perform that type of action. If they can't, they must perform a different type of action. This effect lasts until the start of your next turn or until you use this skill again. So there's a few things to talk about here. If you use a spear, and only if you use a spear, you can use this, which is, like, very limiting. 20 mind points is a lot. And, like, typically, like, this is probably going to be really good on, like, a boss, right? And bosses will typically have, well, like, more mind points than you. So, like, not always, but spending 20 mind points to stop a thing, you know, like there are edge cases where this would work really well. Like, for example, if you're trying to stop the boss from completing an objective, and you've used, like, Breach or something, not Breach, if you've used Bone Crusher to make him lose mind points, right? And then afterwards, when his mind points are really low, you use this and stop him from completing the objective. Like, you can do that. But then if it's a boss, they can, on one turn, use an ultimate point to get MP back and then just do it next turn. So yeah, I don't get it. Like, there are edge cases where this will work. And also, like, at the end, if you read the last sentence, this effect lasts until the start of your next turn or until you use this skill again. Like, It's like I don't get that until you use the skill again, because like if you use the skill again, that'll just happen until your next turn anyway. Like you can use this skill again. Like you can use this after a counterattack because it's not an action. It's when you hit one or more creatures with a melee attack, right? So you could be hit, counterattack, use this. So it's a thing you can do outside of your turn, but then when your turn comes back around, it's your next turn and you don't have that, and it doesn't work anymore. Like I don't know. I don't get it. Like there's edge cases where it will work, but I'm rambling again. Let's move on. Pulverizing Strike is the next one. After you hit a creature with Breach, so you have to have taken Breach, if you attacked with a melee weapon that belongs to the heavy category, you may have the attack deal extra damage equal to your high roll instead of dealing no damage. Any source of extra damage, including the extra damage from the third option of Breach skill itself, still applies. Ignore the damage dealt by the weapon. So if you regularly breach, this deals more damage, which, sounds good on paper, but again, like if we just go back to Powerful Strike means all of your attacks, even the ones without breach, will deal 5 extra damage or 10 if you're level 40 or higher. So like it just doesn't make sense not to take it, Powerful Strike. Like again, unless you want to favor it, and this has like become a common theme among the heroic skills. It's Powerful Strike is just such a standout one, even though it's so simple. The next one is the very next skill, Rising Tide. When you perform a melee attack using a weapon that belongs to the brawling category, if you have no martial armor and no shields equipped, you gain a bravery point. Your melee attacks using weapons that belong to the brawling category deal extra damage equal to your current bravery points. At the end of each scene, or if you have 5 or more bravery points at the end of your turn, you must spend all the accumulated bravery points and recover 10 hit points and mind points. So, think this through, right? You deal extra damage equal to your bravery points. After 5 at the end of your turn, they all get spent. So you can have one kind of turn where you have 5. Like it might go up to 6 if you like, have like 2 weapon fighting or something. So you could potentially deal like 5 and 6 damage at the most. But it's going to take you a few turns to get there. And while getting there, you only get like extra 1 damage and then 2 and then 3 and then 4. So if you're just going for the damage, Powerful Strike outpaces this completely. Like the 10 hit points and mind points recovery is fine. Like there's no, unless you're on like a crisis build where you need to not recover hit points, like there's nothing wrong with recovering hit points and mind points, but it takes 5 turns to recover 10 hit points and 10 mind points when you could just like take Powerful Strike, deal more damage every turn, and then take a turn to heal. Like it's cool, it sounds cool, and it'd be like a fun thing to favor your bravery points as being like you powering up kind of thing, but again, it's just outpaced by Powerful Strike. Spider's Web's the next one. When you perform the attack action with a melee weapon that belongs to the flail category, which is again a very specific category, like a lot of these are, if you have no other weapon equipped, you may perform 2 separate attacks instead of one. If you do, both attacks follow the rules for 2 weapon fighting, so they lose multi-property and can't gain it, and you treat the high roll as being 0 when determining damage, and this doesn't stack with the weapon's quick customization. So this is, even though most of these skills are outpaced by Powerful Strike, this is probably the most useless one in my opinion, at least anyway. So this is a heroic skill, which means you can't take any other heroic skills if you use this, where if you only have a flail, it counts as you having two. So like you can have a flail and a shield, right? And if you don't have the quick customization, then it counts as you having two flails, which is the only kind of situation where this makes sense, right? Otherwise, you can just equip two flails and like, or flail that has quick, and this entire heroic skill is wasted. Like, and you have to use a flail as well. Like, flails are cool, don't get me wrong, they look awesome, but like with how limiting this is and how the effect you get exactly the same as just a customization which you can buy. It's just, I think it's pointless. Like, it's completely pointless. I'm moving on. There's no point. Don't take spider's web. Triple slash. This is the last one. I think it's the last one. Take my notes, yeah. So, as long as you have a one-handed melee weapon that belongs to the dagger or sword categories equipped in each of your normal hand slots, you may treat your armor slot as if it was a second offhand slot. You may only use this special slot to equip a one-handed melee weapon that belongs to the dagger or sword categories. Note that the monkey grip skill does not turn two-handed weapons into one-handed weapons and thus cannot be used in combination with triple slash. When you perform the attack action, while you have three daggers and or swords equipped, you may attack once with each weapon. This follows the normal rules for two weapons fighting, so each of the three attacks loses the multi-property and cannot gain it, and you treat the high roll of each accuracy check as being zero when determining damage. So this is if you want to be Zoro from One Piece, right? So you can have a sword in one hand, a sword in the other hand, and one in your mouth or something. Like, you lose the ability to wear armor. Like, at all. Like, not even, like, simple travel. Like, not even, like, you know, the non... what's the word I'm looking for? Like, the non-martial armors, because you can obviously wear, like, you know, a sage robe or something. You can't with this. So this means that you can attack three times. You know, which is good, you know? Like, and I'm sorry to say this so often, I think it's outpaced by Powerful Strike. Like, I do. Because, like, you can wear armor with Powerful Strike, and the armor can give you stuff. Like, you can have armor that, like, you know, like, makes you immune to conditions and things like that. Like, which you lose out here. Like, it's a cool look, and if you really want to be Zoro, then go for it. You know, extra attacks, you know, are great. But, like, just from a numbers perspective, like, Powerful Strike is just too good. But, yeah. That is the Weapon Master. So lots of heroic skills. Very few of them I'd actually take myself. So yeah, this is it. I'm not going to do another class feature next week. I'm going to try something a bit different. And then I'm going to go back to class features going through the High Fantasy Atlas. And then afterwards the Techno Fantasy Atlas. So even though I'm not going to do one next week, I am going to get to them. They will be covered. But yeah, thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.